Hello viewers, welcome to today's section. Myself Rasmita Jena, lecturer in computer science. So in today's section I am going to discuss the rest of the database concurrent control technique. So in previous video lecture we have discussed on binary locking technique, and in that video lecture we have discussed what are the advantages of binary locking system and what are the disadvantages or arises in binary locking system. And those disadvantages are arises in binary locking system, we will overcome these disadvantages in this video lecture by knowing about the two-phase locking system or share and exclusive locking system. Actually, in binary locking system, what is exactly happen? If there are more than one transaction are waiting for a particular data item, then it will be restricted in binary locking system. That means in binary locking system, is restrictive on the database item, okay, and this will be overcome in share and exclusive locking system. So in binary locking system, as you already know, the disadvantage, it is too restrictive for database item, because at most one transaction can hold a lock on a given time, that I already explained you. Next, suppose that allow several transaction to access the same item X, that means if all the transaction are trying to read the item X, that means all the transaction trying to access the data item X for reading purpose only, then all the transaction can execute read operation without any conflicting. That means if number of transactions are simultaneously trying to read the database item X, then they can. Then next comes to the second point, if the same will happen in case of write operation. However, if a transaction is to write an item X and it must have exclusive access to X, that means if number of transaction are trying to write an item X simultaneously, then it cannot possible in case of binary locking as well as share locking or in two phase locking. So a different type of lock, that is called multiple mode of lock, is used to accessing a particular data item simultaneously in the read propose, but we can't use that data item simultaneously in write propose. So in this video lecture we will discuss the share and exclusive lock, or we can say read and write lock system. In read and write lock system or in two phase locking system, there are three different locking operations are there, that is read lock, write lock and unlock S. And we will discuss briefly about this read lock, write lock and unlock operations. So there are three states. At the time of read lock X, we are in read locked. At the time of write lock X, we are in write locked. At the time of unlock X, we are in unlocked state. So these are the various states of two-phase locking system. As during read lock time, number of transaction can read a single item, so that's why that is called a share lock. That means that data item or that locked item can be shared by number of transaction though it is already locked. So as per our discussion, a read lock item is also called share lock because other transaction are allowed to read the item when that item is locked by the other transaction. Similarly, when we are in write lock, that means whereas the write lock item is called as exclusive lock, because if that was locked by some transaction or by a transaction, then it cannot be used by other transaction. It means a single transaction can exclusively hold the lock on that item, and that transaction can only access that particular item. Okay, so this is about some idea of share and exclusive lock. Then we will discuss briefly what is two-phase locking technique, and in the two-phase locking system, how can we perform read operation. So first we will discuss in two-phase locking the first state, that is read operation or read lock X. In read lock X, we already know about that in a transaction, if one transaction is lock a item on read, on the base of read operation, then that can be shared by other transaction. That's why that is called a share lock. So how can we perform this read lock operation, or how a transaction perform a read lock operation? So first the transaction will check the item is lock or unlock. Suppose the item is X and the transaction want to perform a read lock on item X. So for that, the transaction must first check the state of the data item. That means the data item is lock or unlock. So first condition is, if lockx equals to unlock, then we will, if this condition is true, then we will perform these two statement. Okay, suppose this will be true, then begin lockx as read lock. That means the transaction now lock the item x in the mode of read lock x. Okay, and as we know, it is a shared lock. It can be locked by number of transaction in read mode. So we will be set the number of read x as 1. That means first it was locked as read lock by 1 transaction, then it will be end. Okay, this is when the lock x equals to unlock. Unlock condition is true. But if the lock x equals to unlock condition is false, then we will go for else part of the this if statement. So come to this point, then there another condition, that is, if lock x equals to read lock, that means the item x is already locked by some transaction in read mode. So now another transaction want to lock the same item in read mode. So in that case, we will execute this condition. If this will be true, that is lock x equals to read lock, then we will execute this statement, that is number of read x will be set number of read x plus 1. Okay, that means if the number of read x value is 1, then it will be 2. Okay, after executing this statement. Otherwise, suppose this will be false, that means the item is not locked by any transaction in read mode, then we will go for the else part of this if statement. Comes to this point. So begin, that means if this will be false and this will be false, then we will see that the item x is not locked by read mode, or the item is x is not unlocked. That means the item x is locked in write mode. So come to this point, that means now the item x is used by or locked by, currently the item x is locked by some transaction, and one transaction is trying to execute that lock item x. So what will be the waiting transaction will do? The waiting transaction will wait until that item will be unlocked. So this is the condition, else begin wait until lock x equals to unlock. That means until lock x equals to unlock, the transaction which is wait for the item x, or which is requesting for the item x, will be wait until it will be unlocked. And the lock manager will do what? The lock manager, when it will unlock, the lock manager will work up one of the transaction which are in the waiting queues and assign the data item x to that waiting transaction for accessing the item x. Okay, then in the same process, if you want to if any transaction want to execute that data item x again, then go to step B. Or after executing this step, we will go for the go to B. That means from this location to from this location. So here we will again check if lock x equals to unlock. That means if suppose this is true, then when it will true, then we will execute this. We will, that means the item is unlocked and it will assign to other transaction in read mode. Okay. Or if it will be false, then we will go for the else part of this if. So in this way, we will lock the item x in read mode. So this is about for locking an item in read mode. So we will just see that how a transaction can lock a item in read mode, and when it will be unlocked, how the transaction will wait, and how it will assign the data item x to that particular transaction. And next we will check for the read mode, then next we will check for the write mode. So next we will discuss on how a data item x will be locked in write mode. So this is the algorithm how we can lock a data item in write mode. So if lock x equals to unlock, the same condition, the first we must check the item is lock or unlock. If this item is unlock, then perform this statement. That means if the item is available for the requesting transaction, then the transaction can lock the item as per the need of the transaction. That means as per the read mode or write mode. Here we are discussing on write mode. So the transaction is now locate in write mode. Okay, if this condition is true. If this condition is false, that means if lock X equals to unlock is false, that means the item is already locked by some other transaction. In that case, it will be false. So then from this location too, we will go for else part of this if statement. And then what the transaction will do? The transaction will wait until that item is unlocked. Okay? And when that item is unlocked, the lock manager wake up one of the transaction. That means those transactions are waiting for or requesting for accessing the data item. One of the transaction will wake up by the lock manager, and that data item is assigned to the transaction. Those are waiting for accessing the particular data item. So next we will go for the go to B. That means from this location to we will go for this, and again we will check if lock X equals to unlock. If condition is true, then we will execute this. That means the transaction will lock that item in write mode. If it will be false, then the transaction will wait until the item is unlocked. So this is all about your locking an item in write mode. Locking an item by the transaction in write mode. We just discussing on read mode lock and write mode lock. So after executing read and write mode, as we know that until the transaction is unlocking that particular item, that cannot be used by other transaction. So the transaction must perform unlock operation after using the particular data item. So next we will see how we can unlock a particular data item. So this is the algorithm how the unlock operation is executed. So first it will check the lock X, because the lock X is in write mode or not. If the lock X equals to write mode, if this condition is true, then simply unlock that item. Then it will be free, and that can be availed by any transaction those are requesting for accessing the item X. And the lock manager will wake up one of the waiting transaction, if any. That means if any transaction is waiting for accessing the item X, the lock manager will wake up one of them and assign the item X after unlocking the item X, which is locked in write mode. If this condition is true. If this condition is false, then we will go to this step. That means if the item is not locked in write mode, then we will check the item is locked in read mode or not. So if lock X equals to read mode, if this condition is true, then we will begin to execute this statement. That means, as you know, at the time of read mode, number of transactions can access a particular data item in read mode. So at the time of read locking, we are increasing the number of reads, and when we are unlocking that item that is locked in read mode, we will decrease this number of read value. So for this, we can write number of read X equals to number of read X minus 1. And if number of read X equals to 0, it means all the transactions, those are the locking the item X in read mode, are now unlock the item X when it will be 0. The number of read X equals to 0. Then we will come for the next. That is next, the lock X equals to unlock. That means now the item is unlocked, and lock manager will assign that lock X to one of the transaction that requesting or waiting for accessing item X. Then end. If this condition is false, that means if lock X equals to read lock, if this condition is false, that means the item is unlocked, and any transaction want to access that item can avail. Okay, so this is all about your unlocking operation of a particular data item. So now we are discussing the two phase locking technique, and in from the discussion we know that in two phase locking system, if one data item is locked by transaction in read mode, then that can be accessed by other transaction or that can be locked by other transaction. But if one data item is locked by the transaction in write mode, then that transaction can only access in a exclusive mode. And if both the items, if the item is read lock or write lock, then the transaction after using that data item, the transaction must unlock that data item so that other transactions, though are waiting for accessing that particular item, can access it. So this is all about your two-phase locking technique. And in two-phase locking system, there is some rules and regulations like binary locking system. Let's have a discussion on the rules of two-phase locking techniques. So these are the rules. When we use the share and exclusive locking schema, the system must enforce the following rules that we already discussed, just highlighting the points. The first point, a transaction T must issue the operation read lock X or write lock X before any read item operation is performed in item T. That means if a transaction want to perform read operation or write operation on a particular data item, then the transaction T must issue read lock operation or write lock operation on that particular data item. Otherwise, the transaction cannot access the data item. Okay? Then comes to second point. A transaction T must issue the operation write lock X before any write item X operation is performed. This is mandatory. If a transaction want to perform a write item operation on a particular data item X, okay, then the transaction before that, the transaction must perform a write lock operation on that particular data item before using write operation on that item. Otherwise, the transaction cannot perform a write item X operation on that particular data item. This is the second rule for two-phase locking system for a transaction. Then comes to third point, a transaction T must issue the operation unlock, that I already told about that. After using a data item in read lock X mode, the transaction must issue the unlock X operation. Okay, a transaction T must issue the operation unlock X after all read item X and write item X operation are complete in T. Otherwise, other transaction cannot perform read-write operation on that particular item if it is not unlocked by the currently used transaction. Then comes to fourth point. A transaction T will not issue read-lock X operation if it is already hold a read-lock or write-lock on item X. A transaction T will issue a read-lock operation if it is already hold a read lock X, but the transaction cannot issue a new lock if the data item is locked in write mode. So this is all about the rules of share and exclusive locking or two-phase locking system. So next we will discuss what are the different conversion lock conversions are there. So next we will discuss what are the different lock conversions are there in two-phase locking system. There are two types of lock conversions are there. One is your lock upgradation and second one is your lock downgradation. Upgradation means if one transaction lock a particular item in read mode and if that will be upgraded to write mode. That means if it will be changed from read mode to write mode, then that is called as lock upgradation. Okay, and downgradation means if an item is locked by a transaction in write mode and if it will change to write mode to read mode, then it will called as the downgrade lock conversion. So let's see what is lock conversion. So there are two types of lock conversions are there, that is lock upgrade and lock downgrade. Lock upgrade means existing read lock to write lock. That means the existing lock is read lock and that will be upgraded to write lock. So this is the example. If TI has a read lock X, that means the item X is locked in read mode by a transaction TI, and if TJ has no read lock and TI is not equals to TJ, that means these are two different transactions, TI and TJ, then convert read lock X to write lock X. That process is called as lock upgrade. Else force TI to wait until T is a unlock X. That is known as the lock upgradation. Then downgrade means existing write lock. That means the data item is locked by some transaction in write mode and we are converting this write lock over that data item to read lock. TI has a write lock on X. No transaction can have any lock in X. Suppose other transaction doesn't any lock over the item X, then convert that write lock X to read lock X. TI has a write lock X and convert this write lock X to read lock X, and this process is called as lock downgrade. Converting read lock to write lock is upgradation. Converting write lock to read lock is downgradation. So this is all about your two-phase locking system and the rules for two-phasing locking system and the lock conversion in two-phase locking system. Those disadvantages are arises in binary locking system. Those restrictions are present in binary locking system are overcome in two-phase locking system. So in today's section, we have discussed on two-phase read locking, two-phase write locking system, and two-phase unlocking system. And then we have discussed some rules about two-phase locking system and the different lock conversion in two-phase locking system, that is upgradation and downgradation locking conversion in two-phase locking system. Hope student, you have some knowledge on two-phase locking system. Thank you. Have a nice day.